Good morning, Standard 10.
Today we will start with Chapter 3, Program and Achievement of the Early Nationalist.
Now before we begin with Early Nationalist, you have to understand that the Indian National Movement is divided into three parts: the first phase, second phase, third phase. First phase 1885 to 1905, second phase 1905 to 1919, and third phase 1919 to 1947. This is the national movement divided into three phases. Okay, the first phase, Indian National Congress, was dominated by moderates. Second phase, Indian National Congress was dominated by assertives. Okay, and third phase is known as Gandhian era. So here the acme. Now who were these moderates? The early nationalists were known as moderates, whose method of the national movement was moderate in nature. They were moderate in nature. They were not so aggressive in nature. So we are going to study about early nationalists. We are going to study about the moderates' objectives. It can be called objectives. It can be called programs and demands of the early nationalists. Either it will be objectives or it will be program and demand of the early nationalists. Now again, this program and demand is divided into some parts. Constitutional reforms. Then you have economic reforms. Then you have administrative and other reforms. And then defense of the civil reforms. Okay, so these points we are going to study. So here you have constitutional reforms. Now constitutional reforms, the first point, they demanded the expansion and reform of legislative council. Expansion means they wanted more number of seats in the Indian representatives in the legislative council. This is expansion of the legislative council. Okay. Second, you have, they put forward the claim of Swaraj within the British Empire. In a very simple language, demanded Swaraj within the British Empire. Okay, they demanded Swaraj within the British Empire. Next, you have economic reform. Economic reform demanded reduction of land revenue. Land revenue was very high, so they wanted reduction in the land revenue. They demanded rapid development of modern industries. Modern industry, already we had cotton industries. Small scale industries were there, but they demanded, because industrial revolution first started in England and the raw material was taken to Britain from India. So instead of taking the raw material, what they demanded, they said that you set up the modern industries in India only. So here the moderates, they demanded rapid development of modern industries. They demanded change in the existing pattern of taxation and expenditure. So this was their demand. Next, demanded reduction in the expenditure on army. See, this you have not studied, well, because of the revised syllabus. Army expenditure after the revolt of 1857, increase in the expenditure on army means expenditure of the British government increased. Okay. In the army. So here they wanted, the moderates, they demanded reduction in the expenditure on army and use that money for the welfare of the people. Next we have administrative and other reforms. So many points are there in your book. You learn these three plus one, 4 points. Okay, no separate question, 4 points will be there. They were in favor of Indianization of administrative services. Administrative services means all the high post, they wanted the Indians to be given. So Indianization of administrative services. They wanted repeal of Arms Act and License Act. Okay, repeal of Arms Act and License Act. These two acts were passed by the British government under which the Indians were not allowed to keep the arms, and if at all they keep, they have to have the license. So here, and the same law was not there on applicable on the Europeans. So here they wanted to repeal Arms Act and License Act. They wanted simultaneous examination in India and England for ICS, Indian Civil Service. Okay, Indian Civil Service, like today we have IAS, IPS examination, IAS, this is UPSC examination. Same manner, they were having ICS examination to hold high post in the administration. So here, England there was separate exam, India there was separate exam. So they want, what they demanded? They demanded simultaneous. Simultaneous when the exam held in England, the same time it should held in India. And which examination they are talking about? ICS examination. And defense of civil right, you have to remember that freedom of speech, thought, expression, it was not allowed. So they wanted this should be repealed. Okay, people should be given freedom of press, freedom to express their views, freedom of thought, okay, freedom of speech. These are the rights which they demanded under defense of civil rights. So today's class, you studied program and demands of the early nationalists, constitutional reform, expansion in the legislative council. They put forward the claim of Swaraj within the British Empire. Economic reform, they demanded reduction of land revenue, demanded rapid development of the in modern industries. Then demanded change in the existing pattern of taxation and expenditure, demanded reduction in expenditure on army, administrative reform, put forward the Indian administrative Indianization of administrative services, wanted repeal of Arms Act and License Act, wanted simultaneous examination in India and England for ICS. So please learn this. Thank you.